This conflict defined an entire generation of Americans. 2.7 million brave men and women served in uniform during the undeclared war. 58,000 were killed. The Medal of Honor awarded to 240 soldiers. More than 325,000 Pennsylvanians fought in the war. Stark figures tell the story. 3,147 killed in action. 90 still unaccounted for.
Usually you put your tour in and hopefully made it out of there. A lot of my friends didn't. And there, of course, on the wall, down in Washington, D.C., and they left families behind.
We must never forget the pain, the suffering that lingers today for those who fought with honor and distinction. Those whose loved ones never really made it home. Respect those who honorably served during more than a decade of fighting in the challenging terrains of Southeast Asia. These soldiers faced extraordinary and unprecedented dangers, hampered by a government back home that was uncertain how it wanted to defeat the enemy. For numerous reasons, returning warriors were scorned, harassed, and spat on when they returned to the States. Vietnam vets seldom experienced open arms, applauding crowds, welcome home parades, and shouts of thank you.
And I am still very appalled at the way that we were all treated. When I was at the airport, when I landed on my way back from Vietnam, I took off my boots and I had a trash can in my room. And I dropped my boots in the trash can and I took off my fatigues and I put it on top of my boots and I got into my civilian clothing and I left. And I never had that clothing on again. I was so hurt at the way that we were all treated.
Post-traumatic stress disorder affected some half million vets. Divorce, suicide, alcoholism, and drug addiction were markedly higher upon their return. A 90-year-old bomber pilot and an 80-year-old Army nurse are just two people whose stories you'll hear in Vietnam Veterans of the Valley a half century later. You'll also meet a seriously wounded soldier who went on to play in the NFL, contributing to 4 Super Bowl championships for the Pittsburgh Steelers. A man whose best friend and wrestling partner in high school was killed in Vietnam, and who looks forward to the day when his classmate's body will be found and returned home for burial. A radio operator with the 101st Airborne, who at the Battle of Hamburger Hill was responsible for sending each day's casualty statistics to command. 2 siblings whose brother, a Marine, was killed at the age of 20 and whose sacrifice saved the lives of 10 other men. A U.S. Army advisor to a South Vietnamese artillery unit whose picture was found in the pocket of a dead North Vietnam sniper. A high school teacher who, along with his students, created a permanent wall of honor listing all students in the Vietnam War who attended or graduated from that school district. An Air Force ground crew member who loaded bombs on fighter jets reflecting on Christmas Eve, 1968, in Da Nang. The men and women who fought in the Vietnam War were treated like second-class citizens, even worse, when they returned home to the USA. For years, these warriors kept their stories to themselves, but now their numbers are dwindling. They want to be heard, as do the families of those who never made it home, the casualties of war. That is the intent of this documentary. But it cost money to produce and then air it statewide on the Pennsylvania cable network, PCN. This is where you can help as a sponsor.